On July 10th, the term of office for local council leaders across the country expired. Since then, members of the public have raised concern that the absence of these leaders is likely to cause crisis in villages. Cabinet has, however, come up with some resolutions on this matter. They have unanimously agreed to extend the term of office for these leaders. The extension, which takes effect from July 10th when their term of office expired, will last for 6 months.
The option would have been carry out elections immediately. But you see, carrying out elections is a process. You cannot say, let's do elections tomorrow. You have to prepare many things. That's why we said in the interim, let's approve this extension, and then the government will prepare itself. If we get resources, then we can arrange for elections. And if we don't, then we shall see how it proceeds. So we didn't delve into what happens after the 180 days.
The Minister for Local Government is now expected to put in a request to Parliament to have this decision approved before a notice is issued to the public.
Once the statutory instrument has been laid in the Parliament and is approved, then the Minister of Local Government will issue a notice to the public, a notice of the extension of the term of the local councils. So for now, that's how we are going to proceed, that the cabinet endorsed the proposal that we extend the term for 180 days. 180 days because that's what the law provides for.
The government needs 60 billion shillings to hold local council and women council elections. Report by Juliet Namwaya for the news.